books. Big third period coming up for both teams, and we're ready to go. It's been a fun one so far, all tied up as we are now underway here in the third period. There's the whistle, penalty coming up. The Blackhawks are getting 2 minutes for tripping.
Always a little careless to get a tripping penalty. You get your stick into the player's feet, and when he goes down, you're going to go to the box.
The Ducks will have a chance to get on the power play for the first time this evening.
They've worked on the power play a lot at practice over the last couple of days. This is their first one tonight, and they want to execute what they've worked on, which is to win the draw and start moving the puck.
There's another stop! Not able to connect. Set it on a truck, and that's broken up. And a successful clearing attempt. And the puck leaves the offensive zone. They'll be forced to tag up. Offside the call, and we'll have a faceoff just outside the blue line.
Teammates are going to be thrilled with that stop. That's a tough test on the wrister.
We're still in the early stages of this period. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Ruchin's won the draw here in the open ice. Oh, he moves it! Oh, he completely blew it on that miss.
Yeah, you got to get it on the net, James. You've got an opportunity to score, and you don't even test the goalie.
Sends it quickly to Ruchin. From his own end, he moves it up ahead.
He saw the lane, Dave James. That's a good pass.
And a puck check knocks the puck away. Clearing attempt. And he's able to move the puck across the goal line and out of harm's way. Quick pass across to McDonald. And he slides it quickly to Ruchin. Couldn't complete the play. Roenick's out of the box. He owes a lot of credit to that penalty killing unit.
Well, I really like the penalty kill there. They were on the same page almost all over the ice that entire time. There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
No one home on that play. And the puck stop retains his man to get the extra attacker on the ice. There's the whistle. Penalty coming up. McDonald's not going to like the call, but the officials see tripping on the play.
Fishing around for the puck, and he gets his stick into the player's feet. When he goes down, it's an obvious call.
Chicago sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
You can set a special team trend if your first power play is a positive one. Two get some shots, get some pressure.
And they move the puck out of harm's way. Scooped up along the wall by Seabrook. Keeps a hold of the puck after that knock. Nice pass. Passes right to the front, and that one's broken up. And they get the puck out of harm's way. Possession along the boards. There's the whistle from the linesman calling it offside.
As a great older colleague of mine says, this is waterboarded away.
Lots of hockey left to be played in this period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Niedermeyer's won the draw. And pucks the puck loose inside the offensive end. Way out in front. Slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. The Ducks win the draw. Deep inside the defensive end, still trying to clear, and he gets the job done. Big thumbs up clearing that one. Gains the zone on the left wing. Right in the slot. Puts it into the goal.
Good place to get lost on the ice. The defensemen are down low defending. The forwards are worried about the point. If you can find this high slot play, you often are going to get a one-timer.
Chicago's got the one goal lead here in this third period.
It's starting to look like the goals were going to be really difficult to come by, but they've got another one. Now you want to pressure the team, try and make them make another mistake.
Center pass! Risky play with the puck out of the box! Taken by Jeremy Roenick!
And
clock most of the time to win. There's a good chunk of it.
The Ducks have answered back with a huge goal here in the middle stages of this third period.
It's always dangerous when you chase the game. But now that you've leveled it off, you feel good.
Number 51,
into the last stages of period three.
Dan Fowler. And by number 15, that's Ryan Getzlaff. Time of the goal, 7 minutes, 19
seconds. Takes a shot, stopped by the goaltender. Gibson's going to hang on and just let things settle down for a moment.
You really didn't have many options to play the puck, but in a close game, you want to be sure every time you do.
The Rangers are up next as the extended run of home cooking is about to come to an end here, Razor.
Yeah, the games all just pile on top of each other, and at the end of the year, of course, you play as many at home as you do on the road.
Rocked him in the open ice. Keith's got it in the defensive end. Tries to get it to Roenick. They've got numbers, and forces a huge turnover here with the steal. Knocks the puck away in the open ice. Sends a pass over.
Hollis looks good tonight. He's already got the one goal. He's looking for another.
Tipped along the wall by Compiano. And he slides it quickly to Manson. Handles the puck.
Freeze
and now
it's
stopped. Takes the pass. And now he angles it across to Roenick. The Ducks get a hold of the puck in their own end. And takes a tour out of the offensive end to find some space at center. Past the halfway mark of this period, we got a tie game. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Pass stolen in the open ice.
He's working his way through the offensive zone, Jake. He doesn't have an NHL goal yet.
Wilson's lugging the puck. Moves it over to Savard. There's a big hit against the boards.
You want to squeeze by because you know the middle of the ice is the bad place. You go up the wall sometimes, the door gets slammed.
Here's a shot. Gives them nothing in front. Knocks the puck loose after a solid hit. Oh, he's going to get called on that slash. There goes the whistle. No extra attacker able to get there in time. The Ducks are getting penalized for slashing.
You got to let him go at a certain point here. He gets called for slashing, and that's not a good penalty.
The power play unit goes right back to work.
Well, you can tell these guys must be bubbling with confidence here, James, because they've already scored on the power play tonight.
Penalty
so they
number
get
seven.
Another chance. They must be able to get two minutes
in the tonight. Tries to get it out of the zone.
13
chance
minutes
to breathe for the penalty
seconds.
Killers as they clear the puck.
Oh, solid play. It doesn't have to be the most attractive play, but that puck has to go out.
They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. And they get some breathing room as the puck leaves the defensive end. Chicago's got a hold of it against the wall. And now he moves it quickly to Taze. And a great heads-up defensive play here. Offside is the call that will have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. Puck possession so critical. Another face-off coming up here. Makita's won the draw here in the neutral zone. Reads the play and forces the turnover. Oh, he'll feel that one. Chicago's got the puck at the defensive end. Move in the middle. He scores!
Pretty obvious, James. You play from in front. You've got the advantage. Your team, that goal, gives him the lead. The good thing he one-times his puck. The goalie almost gets there, but the pass is on his tape in the low slot. And he beats him clean.
The Blackhawks take a huge lead here now in the late stages of this one. Question is, can they hang on?
Hanging on is the wrong way to do it. You want to try
Chicago
and be aggressive
goal.
If you can. See if you can build the game away in the other team's end.
Jeremy Chicago's got it in their
assisted
own zone. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that
two.
One.
Well, it's getting to a stage in the game where you think they're not going to be able to find the equalizer, but they stay at it and they get it done. enough air to clear the sticks, and it lands perfectly on the shooter's stick.
Anaheim's late third period goal certainly opens up a lot of decision-making for the coaches, doesn't it?
It does, but they must feel pretty good about their position because they just scored.
Anaheim
I suspect they've got a little bit
nine.
Of a leg
assisted
up, even though the game is tied. Establishes position low in the slot and zips the backhander past the goalie.
Chicago's coaches are pretty active on the bench there, Ray. What do you hear?
Well, they're happy that they've got the lead, but they want to make sure that nobody sits back to defend.
The Ducks get a hold of the puck off the draw.
Scored by number 19, Jonathan.
Chicago's got a hold of the puck off the draw.
Assisted by number 7,
picking up steam.
Great read by the way to take possession with the two-game tied up.
Officials are ready to drop the puck here in overtime. Overtime action is underway. Absolutely love it. Moves around along the half wall. A chance for the win. I can take credit for how this grassroots movement started, but I love the post-game tip of the cap here.
Well, I think any team that doesn't do it now would look like they're missing the boat.
For my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. Thanks so much for joining us. Good night.
A movie, you ain't left your town yet. My only bag is Louis. I got your back like Chewie, but now I'm solo. We don't have to chat about it, do we? I'm getting dope. Well, we got it special, yes, I know. Let's let it grow. That's the MISSIO. Back in the game, I'm traveling. Back in the van, unraveling. Capital gain, I'm dabbling. After the fame, I'm cashing in, no cashing out. Rap performing, got me passing out. As it rain comes after the drought, heaven forming.